I'm Joey Simard-Bauduc, and I'm an ESL teacher in elementary schools. I have three schools, and I work for the Portneuf School Board. At first, I realized that it was difficult for students to write a story, and they didn't really know the steps to write a narrative story in English. So, and I really wanted them to know how to create a good story and what are the elements and the characteristics. There was a theme in one of my schools this year, and it was fairy tales. So I wanted to create a project related to the school theme. So I was thinking, oh, maybe the Three Little Pigs, the Little Red Riding Hood, but I didn't know how to put all of this together. Then we discussed about fairy tales. I presented them a graphic organizer where they had to write examples of fairy tales, non-examples of fairy tales, the characteristics of fairy tales, and then we finished with the definition of what is a fairy tale. I did the project in two of my schools, and in the two schools the definition was not the same, so that made it very interesting.
So my goal in this project was simply for the students to really understand the narrative steps of a story, of a classical story. So they know what a setup looks like, a conflict, challenges, a climax, and also a resolution. They know the characteristics of each step. They can identify them. They can also make their own story. So that was really my goal when they were using Toontastic.
Toontastic is an application on iPads. And there are three options. My favorite one was the narrative classic story. So they had to click on this. And they had all of the steps of a narrative story. So the setup, conflict, challenges, climax, and resolution. What they could do is to simply write each part individually, because all the parts on Toontastic are also done not as a whole, as a whole piece, but it's all separated into all these steps of a narrative story. So the students started to make a huge plan of what will be their, what will be the story. They worked in teams of three or two, and the plan needed to be very good, because after they were writing the parts of the story individually. So it was really important for them to work in collaboration with others and make sure that they were all on the same page as they wrote the story.
This, after is this, after it's you,
it's me,
after this it's Axel,
after it's me.
No, it's the climax, after is this, you say this,
yes,
after it's you,
this one, it's
and after is this one.
Okay, after you, me, I this, I said this, and after you.
Yes, good.
Okay.
In the other part of the project, they're using other bots.
So I would give you big papers, very large papers. I'm coming like this. You'll need some tape. The tape is over there, over there. And then you'll need your markers too to draw the lines. Don't forget, guys, on the lines, it's black. Then you have colors.
And they're using it, and they already read the story of the Little Red Riding Hood, and they're trying to make the Ozzybot move, so it really illustrates the story, and it proves that they really understood the details of all the elements of the story and how it repeats itself with oh, you've got big eyes, you've got a big mouth, you've got big teeth and stuff like that. So these are some characteristics that we saw in fairy tales.
So I used the Ozzybots because they already knew how to use the Ozzybots, and it was quite easy for them to have fun while the other teams were recording their voices. Next time I would do the project differently. I think I would take more time for the project, so they have time to rehearse before they record their voices with Toontastic. Also, as they record their voices on Toontastic, they chose a mood, as I mentioned before, music. And you can choose the volume of the music, so you can put it very loud or very, very low. So it's their choice, but most of them put it very loud, so we cannot hear their voices at all as they talked and animated their characters. When you use ICTs, students have fun, but they don't, and they learn so much, and they don't really realize that it's a learning task. Like when you just give them a paper and you explain to them, okay, these are the narrative steps, let's write a story, and then you write the story and only the teacher reads it, it's not really motivating, and the final product is only for one person, which is the teacher. But when you use Toontastic, it makes it available for everybody. We can watch the movie, it takes 2 minutes, it's not a long time, and the students are not shy because they don't present it in front of the class. It's not, they don't have their paper and read the story. It's a movie that we can project on the board, so it makes them feel way more comfortable. And you can actually see the characters are from the story. You can see the setting. It's just better than just reading a text.